this is not your normal highway. It's also not quite a city street. Yet, it managed to take a simple concept and bring it to a massive scale in an attempt to create a solution for a problem in nearly every American city. And it actually kind of worked. If you've been anywhere around the US, you've probably been on a road like this. In fact, this road is so generic it could be anywhere. But these types of roads are fundamentally flawed. They aim to function as a high-speed road designed to get a lot of cars around quickly, similar to a highway, but they also have businesses and driveways on them, similar to a traditional city street. These are commonly known as stroads. The first problem with stroads is that they're dangerous. With the number of driveways on a road like this, it's full of opportunities for crashes to occur with traffic going in every direction. This is only made worse by the fact that these roads typically have high speed limits. So not only is a crash more likely to occur on a road like this, but the crash is also more likely to be severe, leading to more injuries and deaths. To manage some of this chaos, many of these stroads rely heavily on traffic signals, especially at major intersections. But these obviously stop the flow of traffic, which leads to the next problem. Stroads are inefficient. A traffic light at an intersection between two of these stroads typically functions with a phase for traffic going straight and turning right, along with a phase for left turns, then a phase for the other side to go straight and turn right, and then another phase for their left turns. The order can vary depending on how the light is set up, but this is a very common configuration. But all of these different phases require a certain amount of time to ensure traffic in each direction has a chance to go. And when the light doesn't provide enough time for all of the traffic to clear through the intersection, it can start to back up, leading to delays. So how do you make these stroads better? It depends on what the goal is. The biggest problem with stroads is the fact that they're trying to be two things at once. So in order to make a better stroad, it's going to take picking a side. Do you want it to get you between places, or do you want it to be a place? A road or a street? We'll look at both, but first, let's talk about how we can create a better road. To be an effective road, we need to understand that the priority is to move vehicles safely and efficiently. Typically, the best way to do this is by ensuring vehicles can move freely. Something like a divided, limited access freeway is considered to be a good way to do this by balancing both safety and efficiency. The lack of intersections and the physical separation between each side keeps everyone moving and reduces potential conflict between vehicles. But this requires significant physical infrastructure with overpasses and entrance and exit ramps. Not only is this expensive, but when placed in urban settings, can separate neighborhoods and create physical barriers, walling off communities from each other. But what if you could have similar functionality to a highway, but keep it all at grade without requiring overpasses or exits, and still keep business access in the process? Well, Michigan tried doing just that. This is Hall Road, located in the northern suburbs of Detroit. And this road is infamous for, well, no, not that, but rather being a massive commercial corridor that uses a unique design concept commonly referred to as the Michigan Left, to keep tons of traffic moving efficiently. Here's how it works. The entire road functions kind of like a freeway with two massive one-way roads side by side. In most spots, it's four lanes in each direction designed to handle tons of traffic. But unlike a freeway, there are no grade-separated exits. Instead, you just turn right, and only right, when you're getting on or off the road. No waiting to cut across both directions of traffic, no left turns backing up an intersection, just steady, same direction flow. This is the first key to its efficiency. Because everyone's turning right, every driver is moving with the flow of traffic, which helps greatly with keeping things moving. But what about the people who do need to turn left? This is where the second part of the Michigan Left comes in. The road is designed with designated U-turn lanes that allow you to cross over to the other side moving in the opposite direction. At first glance, this probably doesn't seem efficient at all. I mean, you have to drive in the total opposite direction just to turn around. And in terms of distance, yes, it is longer. But in terms of time, it can actually get you on your way quicker. If you've ever tried turning left on a busy road, you know the feeling of looking left, then looking right, then looking left, and just waiting for the perfect opportunity for both sides to be clear so you can finally turn. Not only is this really stressful, but on a busy road, it can take forever to find a gap to actually go. With the Michigan Left design, by splitting up each direction of traffic, it means you only have to find a gap in one direction at a time before going, and can get you on your way quicker. At intersections, the same principle applies. No left turns allowed. While you can go straight through to continue past Hall Road, if you actually want to get on it, you have to turn right, then either continue on, or do a U-turn if needed. With all of the traffic going straight or right, it only requires one phase for each direction. There never has to be a left turn phase because there are no left turns. With less phases overall, it shortens the amount of time you have to wait meaning traffic can continue on quicker than if they had to wait for left turns. But what's interesting about this too is that it doesn't add time for people turning left. It just changes where they wait. For example, this car will be turning left, they just have to do a U-turn first. Let's pretend there is a left turn lane here though, with this being a pretend car needing to turn left. By the time this phase ends and the left turn would receive their green arrow, the car making the U-turn is going at the same time, along with all of the other traffic from that direction. Yet, it didn't require dedicating a whole phase for left-turning traffic. And this is the key that makes this road so efficient. Because there are only two phases, it allows the signals to easily be timed together as one connected system that wouldn't be possible if it wasn't for the U-turns. The signals are set up to create blocks of traffic that, once you're in one, you can continue traveling and hit every light right as it turns green. This allows you to continue traveling for several miles without stopping, provided you're traveling at the speed limit. This setup allows this road to handle an average of over 80,000 cars per day. This is a huge amount of traffic, especially for a road that isn't a fully divided freeway. In fact, it's the only road in the entire Metro Detroit region that has this level of traffic without being a fully divided freeway. And the benefits go beyond just efficiency. But first, you've probably noticed all the drone footage in this video. This is real-life footage of actual cars driving on an actual road, not AI or some simulation. And we know how valuable that can be when conveying information like this. This is why we're proud to have Storyblocks as the sponsor of this video, as they provide authentic stock content created by real artists. They know that capturing media is for humans, and in doing so, it should highlight the real human experience, capturing stories and emotions that AI can't replicate. Chances are, if you're watching this video, you've probably wanted to make your own video about roads, or maybe you wanted to make a cinematic masterpiece. Regardless, step one of creating a video is having video footage. And this is where Storyblocks can be a great first step. They offer unlimited downloads of diverse and high-quality media for one predictable subscription cost. And it goes further than just video, too. You can get templates, music, sound effects, images, and more to make sure you have the content you need to begin telling your story. As someone who creates videos, having this content can be a huge step up in terms of saving time and increasing your production value. Stuff like these motion graphics can take forever to do manually. But with templates that link directly within Adobe software, it makes it much easier. They have monthly or annual plans with no hidden or extra fees, and all of the content is curated and updated regularly, ensuring that you're getting fresh new content over time. To get started with unlimited stock media downloads at one set price, head to storyblocks.com/streetcraft or click the link in the description. While the entire setup of Hall Road helps with efficiency, it can also improve driver safety in a few ways. Typically, left turns are some of the riskiest maneuvers, as they cross multiple paths of traffic from different directions. These create conflict points where crashes can occur. The more conflict points, the more opportunities for a crash to happen. So anytime you can reduce the number of conflict points, you also reduce the potential of a crash occurring. By eliminating the left turn conflicts with the U-turn setup, it not only reduces the number of conflict points at intersections, but it also changes driver behavior. Splitting up the left turn movements into two separate maneuvers helps with efficiency because it lets you find a gap in each direction of traffic separately, but this also is much less stressful for drivers. You only have to watch one direction of traffic at a time, reducing the chance of misjudging a gap and causing a crash. The way the traffic signals are optimized can also help with safety, as the continuous flow can help prevent rear-end crashes by reducing the stop-and-go movements. But this isn't a perfect solution. As with any road, heavy traffic can disrupt the flow of vehicles, and it's still a high-speed, multi-lane roadway that, despite efforts to reduce conflict points, still has tons of opportunities for serious crashes to occur. This is just the reality of building a road of this scale with this level of speed. It also takes up tons of space. The large median provides space for all of the U-turn lanes, all of which have the capacity to hold several cars waiting without backing up into the through lanes. This is due more to the massive scale of this particular road, though, not necessarily U-turns themselves. And we'll look at how it can be done with a fraction of the space in a bit. It's not necessarily great for pedestrians either. Part of this is just the nature of a road this size. A sprawling suburban commercial corridor is never necessarily going to be a fun place to walk, but there are sidewalks, and they did create designated pedestrian crossings at signals. Compared to some stroads that don't even have sidewalks, there is at least the infrastructure to walk here if you would choose to do so. Like we said at the beginning of the video, creating a better stroad takes picking a side. Hall Road leaned into being a road. And arguably, this is the right direction given the context and purpose it's trying to serve. It's located in a large, car-centric commercial corridor and requires moving tons of vehicles to and from all of these places. It's not trying to be a place. And this is why it works. So what about the stroads that don't need to carry 80,000 cars a day or are located in areas that have the opportunity to become vibrant, safe, walkable places, but are currently being divided by these large, dangerous stroads? In that case, it's time to pick the other side and redesign the stroad as a street. Let's look at how we can take some of these same principles and shrink them down to create safer, more livable places. First, let's look at the U-turns themselves. This same design concept can be used not only to create a better road, but a better street too. The problem with most roads is they don't have 350 feet of right-of-way like Hall Road does, so fitting in the actual spots to turn around can be a challenge, as these are what require space, particularly for large vehicles. But the street itself doesn't require any additional width to add U-turns, only the spots where the U-turns occur. To accommodate this, some roads that have a fairly narrow median extend the pavement to give large vehicles that extra space they need to make the U-turn. But there's also another tool that has U-turns built right into its design, the roundabout. Let's take a look at this road outside of Portland, Oregon as an example of how we can implement this design. Right now, the road is cluttered with side streets, driveways, and parking lot entrances, feeding into each other from all directions. This creates a mess of conflict points, making it dangerous for everyone. The traffic signals require multiple phases, adding to vehicle delays, and sidewalks for pedestrians are terrible. Yet, it runs right through a residential area and has the potential to be a place for people to actually hang out at and get around safely, rather than the dangerous mess that it is right now. This requires changing the priorities, though, and taking a different approach. First, we need to slow down vehicle speeds. This is one of the best ways to improve safety for everyone. But this doesn't necessarily mean increasing travel time. We'll prioritize keeping traffic moving instead of speeding through only to have to sit and wait at a red light, and we'll limit access points. Not only does this help to keep traffic moving, but it also eliminates conflict points, therefore improving safety. To do this, we'll modify the road like so, changing each of these intersections into roundabouts instead. This will allow the traffic to continue moving and also serve as points to make U-turns and access side streets. It also reroutes this street up here to simplify the intersection while maintaining business access from the side streets. Because of the curves of a roundabout, it forces vehicle speeds to remain low through this section, but keeps traffic moving. And removing driveways directly from this road allows it to focus on getting traffic through efficiently. With a setup like this, it would also allow this entire area to evolve over time. They could prioritize street-facing businesses, creating a sense of place rather than just parking lots. Parking could be consolidated into parking garages or well-placed lots, and instead, a shift towards creating a more walkable space could fill what was previously parking lots with green space, outdoor dining areas, and public parks. Bike infrastructure and public transportation facilities could also be improved with this design, creating even more options for people to get around. And at the same time, it would still allow for vehicles to pass through this area efficiently, but also safely. Of course, this is just a small section of this street, but it could be expanded further, and not every intersection would need to be a roundabout either. It's possible to combine roundabouts and U-turns in the median on a street like this if there's space available. The concept of replacing left turns with U-turns is the design concept that can be used to not only improve safety on roads, but also create well-functioning streets. A firm called Urban Innovators has explored this concept even further, looking at how acquiring small pieces of right-of-way and parking lots can make space for U-turn lanes in order to transform a stroad into creating a place that promotes more walkable development over time. They dive deeper into the specifics and provide design variations that can be applied if you're interested in learning more about the engineering behind this concept, and their website is linked below. So, whether you're building a road or a street, the most important decision is to figure out what you want that space to be. And in the case of a stroad, well, that's not always clear, and that's why it takes figuring out what you want to prioritize when it comes to building roads. And there's actually a lot more to consider than you might think, with everything from noise pollution to land use. And this next video goes into depth as to why we've chosen to create traffic with what we've prioritized.